Welcome back, everybody. So I'm very sorry for the delay in between videos. As we all know, life gets super busy sometimes and things out of your control happen, which is what I have been going through in the last couple of weeks. But I feel like we're back on track now. So as you can see, there is carbon wrap on the hood of the ski. I did those shorts a couple of weeks ago and I got some mixed feedback, but I've decided to go with the carbon wrap, at least on the bonnet for this stage. I haven't wrapped much in my past. I've done some mirrors and some bits and pieces like that on cars and a bit of stuff on it, machines. Put plenty of stickers on, so I'm just going to throw caution to the wind and say it's basically the same principle. But this video is basically going to show how tricky this is going to be, I guess. And if it doesn't work, you'll see that it doesn't work as well. I'm not going to just not post a video of something that doesn't work. I'm not like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start on this side here of the bonnet. I've got excess down that side because I'm not sure how much I'm going to need by the time I go in down in here. I've got two clamps holding the wrap on the side. I've just got myself a little work platform here. So I'm going to start on this side. I'm going to set that in place and then work my way over following the contours. So this is either going to be really, really good or it's going to be really, really bad. Let's see how we go. Right, so update time. I'm really struggling getting this edge not to crinkle, and I think it's because I've got a 90 degree turn going down, and then this is also an arch like that. So I'm sure if you were you did this for a living, you'd probably be able to get it in a decent amount of time. So far I've spent about half an hour, 45 minutes just on this piece here, which I'm burning time. So what I'm going to do is just change my plan of attack a little bit with it, and then see how we go from there. Thank you. So sit rep, what have I been able to achieve? A bit of swearing, which you won't hear in the video, but I wasn't able to get, as I said, that to match that with that. There was just too much stretching involved, and I guess basically I haven't had enough experience, and I'm not sure if it's even possible with this sort of stuff to be able to pull it and stretch it that much. But anyway, what I'm going to do is I sort of had a thought of think about it and realize that in here there's a foam pad that runs across here anyway for the straps. So I've just cut it, I've tucked it down nice and neat through there. I've got to do both the ends now, so I'll jump onto doing those. I'll just give you a quick shot of the inside of that. So like I said, sorry for the flickering lights, I've run this down here, pushed in. There's a couple of lumps in here because the resin underneath is not great, but you're not going to see it anyway because, like I said, the foam will run across about that height. So I've got all that tucked in and on. Now I'm just going to work on the two ends. So after persisting with this for probably 3 hours on and off camera, you'll see a little bit of it. This is going to be a bit of a prequel to the intro that you're going to see. So I've decided to pull the pin on the wrap. I'll give you a couple of shots in a second as to why I've decided to do that. It's just not good enough for what I want. Basically, I want the ski to be super presentable, super good finish on it, and I'm not going to get that with the wrap. So I'll give you a couple of shots now with what the outcome is, and you'll see why I'm not happy with it. So as you can see on the side, it actually looks pretty good. There's a couple of little bumps here and there where there's faults in the resin coat below. Over the top, like you would have seen a couple of the clips, it's not too bad through here. This is less than ideal. I really don't like that. It would be covered with foam, but it's just not what I want. This sort of corner here, this stuff's not too bad. But then when I get to these corners here, and I hope the light's not blocking it too much, but you'll see there's ripples. Like I tried for probably this patch here, I probably spent half an hour on trying to pull, stretch, heat, manipulate to get to the way I wanted it, but I can't get it right. And that's either probably one of three things: user error, potentially, the product is just not capable of doing it. I'm not sure. I'm sure if you're a pro, then and all you do all day, every day is wrap, then you'd probably be able to get it. But like I said, I haven't been able to get it the way I want it. And I really don't like the finish in the corner. I had to cut on an angle down through there to get the sheets to lap properly. And then I thought, well, if it's in the water, I really don't want to give it an edge where it can peel, which is probably what will happen. It'll probably peel after time. So I've just decided to pull the pin on the idea of wrapping. So like I said, in the short and previously, What you just saw took me basically 3 minutes to get off. Took me 3.5 hours to put on last week, so or a few days ago. So great product. I wish it had worked. I might still do something on here with that, but I'm just gonna go for a sprayed gloss black finish on it, like the hull, polish it up and get it nice and shiny. So let's prep this now and get it ready for paint. I'd like to get some paint on this today. It's perfect weather for painting. It's 21 degrees here Celsius, which is just absolutely spot on. Very, very good humidity rating as well. So I'll get this prepped up and mix up some paint and we'll get spraying. So on here, there's these two little wear pieces of vinyl just to help protect the hull. So I'm just gonna peel them off now. Like I said, give this a bit of a once over, a very light sand and a Scotch-Brite, which I'll show you, just to give the new paint something to grab onto with its first coat. So where are we at? You would have seen me with the Scotch-Brite. I was just using Scotch-Brite and methylated spirits just to break down any of the surface contaminants and help basically lift anything out of the paint that was already there. The Scotch-Brite does take a little bit of the clear coat gel off, or clear coat, which is fine because I want it to be a rough surface for the next stage of paint to adhere to. So I'm just gonna now go over both the stem and the hood with a wax and grease remover and then hit it with a primer. Thank you. now that I've taken off that that rubber seal that was just absolutely cooked, I've scratched it off with that little scraper. Now I'll go through there with a nice brush on the drill, or even by hand, and just clean all that residue out of there. So I just want to paint it as well, so it's resealed again. That way when the rubber goes in, you won't see anything. All right, let's start working on that, get all that rubbish off there, and then last things last, we'll work on this nose and get that tidied up, that edge, and get it ready for prime. Thank you. Just about to shoot my third coat and my guns failed, which is part of life, it's what happens. But I think what I'm gonna have to do in the aid of getting this video out so you guys still feel the love from me is to end the video here with two coats of the base on, and then sort out the gun, either grab a new one or get it fixed, and then shoot the last coat of base and then the clears over that in the next video during the week. So I think I'll end it here, guys. It's been a lot of sped up sound over sort of action in this one. Next one I'll talk to a bit more of the painting process, so keep your ears open for that, and I'll get onto it ASAP. So thanks for watching. Thanks for your patience between this video and the last video. Please share the videos. It's great to see the channel growing, like I've always said. So share them around, give me a thumbs up, love it, and I'll catch you next week. Have a safe week, everyone. All right, slightly different clothes. I'm just filming the ending of this video again, purely because when I filmed it last night, I was trying to shoot a couple of shots and my GoPro died, which is probably fair enough. I've had it running pretty flat out for the past few days. So yeah, just gonna give you some shots of it with the clear coat on it. It has to be polished, which obviously will make it that glassy look. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out, to be honest. I did have a problem with the gun, as you would have seen a bit earlier on in the video, that text that I put up. So it was funny, it was just one of the little ports was blocked in it, and I just sort of thought, why is this not working? And then looked at it for 5 minutes and then worked out what was wrong with it. So it's always good to have a bit of a look before you give up. So I'll show you the ski. It is a little bit dusty because this is the day after I finished shooting it, but that's all good. It will get polished. I'll show you the ski, the hood, and also the neck. You can see for yourself how it turned out. Now, one thing I will say is there is some hardware on this, some screws and that sort of stuff, which I have left and I have painted them. There is a reason for that. I'm gonna keep that in my head for the moment, but you'll probably see why a little bit later on. So here we go, finished product. So I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. You can even see sort of my reflection there. There are a couple of imperfections, but you know what? I can live with that. I'm happy with that. As I move up over here, this plate where obviously the HydroTurf will sit, I didn't put too much of the clear over it, and I didn't do that because I actually didn't want it to build up too much. I want this to be a nice sort of a nice surface for that stuff to stick to. You can see how much dust has come in here overnight. My fingerprints are just on there now. So as you can see, all that control area, that's all nice and painted. That'll obviously have a plate over it. Coming around here, this is the hardware I was talking about. Back. And we'll move around the side. Here's the neck. There was a couple of imperfections that got left in this, and I'm not going to hide them, they're there. But this will look great after a polish. And then last but not least, the hood. The hood actually turned out a little bit scratchy. I think the last batch I put on it was just a little bit light on the acrylic thinner, but that's okay. I'm sure a little bit of polish will take that. It's quite dusty. I don't really want to wipe my hands over it too much. But as you can see, a nice shiny finish to be had on that. All right, so like I said, I'm really actually relieved that that's all done, because it was starting to sort of wow me a little bit that it's taking so long. But next video will be a reassembly of the body, putting that back together, the next stem. I really want to jump on the motor. I've just been a bit low on time. I want to soda blast that if I can and make that look really schmick before it goes back in again. And then we've just got reassembly, which is going to be great. I'm going to highlight the black with some stickers. I've got a few different ideas for that. Please feel free to put them down below in the comments if you do have any ideas on stickers or color schemes. Love to hear them. I love reading them. Videos left. It's still a bit cool to get in the water. Not making excuses for my deadline that I've run over, but I reckon another few weeks and we'll be out on the water. So stay tuned. Please share the channel, like it, subscribe, get your mates to subscribe, your friends. Let me know where you're from. Let me know where you're viewing from. I love seeing when people comment from overseas. It's really cool just to see how far a little channel can sort of reach around the world. So stay safe, have a great week, and I'll see you next week for the next installment of the Stand Up Jet Ski. Thanks everyone, catch you soon.